Hello, this is Dusty, and we're going to be bombing Dusseldorf number 3 in a DB7 from 5 kilometers. You can see below some resource information and altitude information regarding factories, and a little math at the bottom as far as how we're going to set our bomb site altitude. These following pages will just walk through selecting a pilot and selecting your bombing squadron and the basics of putting a mission together. Missions, I typically set my origin and my target as the same points. And I now am selecting the DB7. Now I'll go back to the map and I'm going to set up my target and waypoints. What you'll notice here is I'm going to head over to Dussel. And expand the map out a little bit. And set our target dead center on Factory 3. I type in Deuce number 3 as my target name. And you can add a comment here. Helps if you have multiple people on your mission. Now watch this area here as I hover over the target. You have an east, west bearing and a north bearing. If you're going to bomb from west to east, you use that north bearing. If you're going to bomb from north to south, you're going to use the east bearing. So it so happened that as I'm setting R1 here, I'm going to set it for that bearing, which I believe was 51151. All right, this is R1. This is the point where you open your bomb site. Now I'll set R2 to the same north bearing, which was 51151. And I use R2 to do my final tuning before I select the target. So from R2, this is where I set the target. And the last waypoint that we're going to set here, I'm going to call climb or climb here. Same bearing, that 51151. And this is where you're initially going to set your bearings to get your altitude. So you're going to climb out to 5 kilometers with your bearings set to this waypoint. So now we're going to select our DB7, jump into it, get into the mission. And into the world we go. And there we are. Now we're going to set that bomb site altitude. Depending on how your key mapper is set up, you're going to move your altitude up until we hit that value that showed up in the opening credit of, Dusseldorf, it'll be close to 4959. So just watch that area on the upper left-hand corner, and we're going to want to set that bomb site altitude to 4959, plus or minus 3 to 5. All right? Then after that, you're going to run your speed up all the way. It's just very important that you have both of these set, just as I show them here, for your best chances at success. Before we leave the bomber, just make sure you never touch your bomb, your joystick whenever you're on site. We're going to jump to the pilot now, and I like to set my flaps for 20%, and also like setting my engine for max RPM. So you'll see me going through that. We're going to power up the engines and set WEP to on. All right. Now you can see I've going to choose my climb waypoint. Going to center the map on me to that. And now we're going to take off. Just throttle up. And gain enough speed to where you can get off the ground. When you gain enough speed to get off the ground, make sure you raise your gear, and that'll be indicated by the little red light in the upper left corner of your forward windscreen, just below the brace bar. So I'm going to take off here, and I'm up. I'm going to raise my gear now, and using the mini map in the corner, I'm going to set my bearing, my green arrow, to what that climb waypoint is. And once you see the indicator for your plane line right up to that green arrow, you'll know that your bearing is good. And now I'll level out and gain some speed. What's important here is don't climb too quickly. Get some speed, and then once you get about where I am here, I think it's about 300, then you can slowly ease back the stick and go to a climb rate of 12, and we're going to, from there, climb to your 5K. Now, what I like to do is go to the instrument view and fine-tune your approach, and then just sweeten up your climb using the left-right indicator. And once you've got your arrow set dead to the center, you just want to try to keep your marker right in the middle of that bubble between left and right. DB7 loves to drift to the right. That's partially, or mostly, I think, because you're right-handed, and that's the direction that your joystick is going to want to pull you. So we're going to just go from here to 5K. Okay, we're at 5K, and it's time to trim out the plane. And trimming is getting your flaps back to 0%, moving your WEP off, getting yourself to a continuous engine speed, and selecting your next waypoint. So we'll see all of those things going on as I move between the instrument view and the pilot view here. So right now, what you'll see is that I'm sweetening up my bearing using the mini map to get me to R2, which was the waypoint that I wanted to set myself up for. So my WEP is off, flaps are at zero, I'm at continuous speed, and now we're going to select R2 and fine-tune our course in. And that's what you're going to see me doing there. And just magnify out your main map as high as you can and try to get the point of that arrow as close as possible to splitting, with no white or black showing as you tune that in. Another important thing that you'll see, a reminder, is to get your angle of attack as close to zero as you possibly can. That's shown in the upper left-hand corner. So right now we're going to just check the factory damage, get a starting point. You'll see it's at about, 40-something percent as I type that in and check it. Now you can see we're approaching R2, and you're going to set your waypoint now to deuce 3. Again, this is your final check to sweeten everything up and get yourself dialed right in. This is your last chance, really, to have any chance to correct anything. Okay, so we're now at R1, we're opening our bay doors, and we're going to go to our scope. I always do a little bit of final check there at R1. Of my bearing, and now you can see I'm in my bombardier position. That just opened the bomb bay doors, and now I'm going to go to my scope, or your bomb sight. All right, there we are. Going to be dropping on scope here in just a moment, and there we are, full magnification. All right, now depending on the weather, you may have an easy ride in, or depending on how the clouds are, it could be that you're fogged out. And unfortunately, we got fogged out as we made our approach here. Now, the reason it actually worked out good to have this happen is so that you don't panic and abort the attack, or even worse, you panic and you drop your bombs even though you're not over the factory. You can see we just passed the factory there. A lot of guys will dive bomb if they get fogged out, but I like to try to save the plane. So what I'll do is I'll fly out two sectors past the target, and then I'll just turn around and use the same method to reapproach as I did on the initial approach. So one real important thing here is as you're making this turn, try to keep that variometer as close to zero as possible. You don't want to gain or lose altitude. So you are making a very, very short, sharp turn, but you do also want to make sure you're not climbing or diving and changing your altitude or your speed too much through this turn. So you can see me dialing in here and getting lined up. I'll probably use a little more magnification so that I can make sure that I'm really dialed in, that my arrow is splitting the black and the white, which it is. And I'll pop in, once I'm there, I'll pop into autopilot. There we go. And as soon as you see me drop the map, I'll be in autopilot and we'll go back to the bombardier position, make sure that bomb bay is open, go back on the scope. And what I've always found is if you're fogged out in one direction, you're never fogged out in the other direction. So here we go. There's Dusseldorf. Let's get ready. A little bit of fog. Drop your bombs just as the center hair on your bomb sight crosses the near wall. Drop over to position 4. Go to your gun position and just train that sight of the gun over the factory, your target. And when your bombs hit, you'll see what look like a bunch of flash bulbs on a camera going off. And that is the most satisfying part of this journey here. And there they go. So now that you've got your visual confirmation, you can jump out of position 4, close your bomb bay doors, and then basically type in .fac, and you should see that your bombs have hit and you've done about 20% more damage to your target. And that's typical for 8 bombs dropped. That's it, guys.